I now give the floor to the distinguished representative of Pakistan.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Let me congratulate you and other members of the Bureau on your election. Today I will focus on agenda items 27, 73, and 74. Mr. Chair, the right of peoples to self-determination, enunciated in Article 1 of the UN Charter and Common Article 2 of the two international human rights covenants, is a foundation for the enjoyment of civil, political, economic, social, and cultural rights, including the right to development. The General Assembly has also reaffirmed its abiding commitment to the right to self-determination in several landmark resolutions, including Resolution 1514, Resolution 2625, and Resolution 2649. The right to self-determination was a legal and moral justification for the process of decolonization. Yet, the exercise of this right has been denied to some peoples, such as the people of Jammu and Kashmir and Palestine. Mr. Chair, for over seven decades, in contravention of numerous Security Council resolutions, the people of Indian illegally occupied Jammu and Kashmir have been denied their recognized right to self-determination by India through oppression, obfuscation, and intransigence. Since 5 August 2019, India gave up all pretense and proceeded to outright annexation of occupied Jammu and Kashmir in what its extremist rulers have ominously called a final solution. Since 5 August 2019, through its unilateral illegal actions, India imprisoned the entire Kashmiri political leadership, illegally detained 13,000 Kashmiri youth, tortured many of them, extrajudicially killed hundreds of young Kashmiri boys, used rape as a weapon of war, put down peaceful protests violently, blinding even young children with pellet guns, imposed collective punishments by demolishing and burning entire neighborhoods and villages, and curtailed the freedom of religion and expression. In blatant violation of Security Council resolutions and international law, India has introduced new and arbitrary domicile rules to transform Kashmir's Muslim majority into a dispossessed and dispersed minority in their own homeland. Due to officially prescribed impunity, not a single Indian soldier has been punished for these crimes. Mr. Chair, all of this is well documented in the reports of the High Commissioner for Human Rights in 2018 and 2019. My government has also unveiled a dossier on 12 September providing concrete evidence of India's crimes in Kashmir. We await implementation of the Security Council resolutions prescribing a plebiscite to enable the Kashmiri people to exercise their right to self-determination. We await global condemnation of India's human rights violations in occupied Kashmir. Meanwhile, we urge the General Assembly to ask India to accept the recommendation of the UN High Commissioner for Human Rights to set up an inquiry commission to investigate the human rights violations in occupied Jammu and Kashmir. Mr. Chair, expressions of racial hatred, religious supremacy, and violent nationalism have escalated in several parts of the world. Islamophobia is a pernicious manifestation of racism and hate, which we must collectively combat. We are happy that the declaration on the 20th anniversary Durban conference has recognized Islamophobia as a contemporary form of racism. Islamophobia has become official policy in India, where Muslims are being disenfranchised, oppressed, evicted from their homes, and killed with impunity. My Prime Minister has proposed that the Secretary General convene a global dialogue on countering the rise of Islamophobia. I would also reiterate the OIC's call to designate an international day to combat Islamophobia. Mr. Chair, peace and development is the best pathway to the promotion of human rights. As my Prime Minister has said, China's experience can be a source of guidance for all developing countries. We fully support President Xi Jinping's global development initiative. I thank you, sir.
I thank the distinguished representative of Pakistan for his statement.